I was lucky enough to be able to make two more films entirely in black and white, and they were both shot in Berlin. And in those years, every time I visited Berlin, I used to go walk through the streets with this silly grin on my face because I just loved hearing the familiar accents. Berlin has a very colourful local accent, just like Cockney in London. And I just loved to hear that. And so I used to walk through the streets with a silly grin on my face. So the first of these black and white films was for a director called Hans Noever, whom you could say was a sort of on the edge of the German New Wave, if there is such a thing, with Fassbinder and the others. And Wenders and Fassbinder. Noever was a sort of minor character in that respect, but a very interesting guy, very full of humor, very, very funny, and quite talented. And he wrote the script as well as directing this film, which is called Die Frau gegenüber, which means the woman opposite, or The Woman Across the Way it was called in English, because there's already a film called The Woman Opposite, I think. And this film is set in, it uses Berlin as the big city. It's recognizably Berlin, but it doesn't have to be Berlin. It's just the character of the city. The city is a character in the story. And the story is about an obsessive husband who keeps thinking that his wife, who is completely innocent, is deceiving him in some way. So he devises this plot that he says he's going away for a few weeks, and he disguises himself, he dyes his hair, and he moves into a block of flats which has a direct view onto the balcony of the flat that he's living with his wife. And then he just spies on her, as it were. And before that, he's introduced his wife, who's a shy country girl, to his friend. He's an insurance assessor. So in the office where they work, he has his friend. And before he goes away, he introduces his wife to this friend, more or less to see if she's tempted or if she can catch her doing something she shouldn't be doing. Which indeed he does, but it's very much due to him that he's put them in that position. And the husband is played by a Polish actor, Franciszek Pieczka, who was excellent, who is really excellent. And the wife was a relatively unknown German actor. Well, she was sort of known in Germany, but not well, and she wasn't a star. And the friend was played by an amateur, actually, who was also the assistant director. I think he used the name of Jody Buchmann for his acting work. And as I said, the city is the sort of a character in the plot. And we use the S-Bahn, the overhead railway in the overhead metro in Berlin. There's an underground, but there's also an overground. And we use that as punctuation in the story. Every now and then you just get this shot of this little S-Bahn train going across the picture. And that worked very well. And the black and white is very, I think that film wouldn't be a patch of what it is in colour, wouldn't be anything like as good, because the black and white, as I've said many times already, enables you to stylize things, and you're not distracted by extraneous things, as you might be if it were in colour. The S-Bahn, for instance, is yellow and red, much better than it's in black and white, much better.